So we're talking about policy agendas and policy agenda setting, and I'd like to focus in on the idea of iron triangles. So the iron triangle is composed of congressional committees, executive agencies, and interest groups. And it's very important to understand the iron triangle and how it works in politics, because much of what goes on within government takes place pretty much out of the public eye. And only really people that are what we would call attentive publics, or people that have a great interest in a public policy, would really be following the minutiae of public policy on any given time. And the iron triangle then is a congressional committee dealing with a specific public policy, say transportation in this issue, in this instance. So in, for example, the House of Representatives, that would be the House Transportation and Infrastructure Committee. You'd have an executive agency, like the U.S. Department of Transportation, that would be related to transportation. And then you'd have interest groups that would be interested in transportation. Things like the American Road and Transportation Builders Association, or various state and local government organizations, or concrete makers, or macadam makers, all these types of things that are interested in transportation policy. Now, what you're not going to have here are things, say, for example, involved in agriculture or defense, because that's not part of this issue of transportation. It's a tightly knit community that basically focuses in only on a single type of issues, and that's why it's called the Iron Triangle. And the three of these groups then work together to negotiate public policies. So, just a quick look at this. So, on the interest group side, you might have business, labor, public interest groups that are interested, say, for example, with this transportation example. One thing that public interest groups are interested in is more public transportation and less carbon emissions. So they might be, environmental groups might be focused on, alternative sources of transportation. State and local government officials are involved in pretty much every issue, primarily because of the fact that they are the ones that implement federal policy at a lot of different levels and carry out those policies. Individual companies may be involved if it involves regulation of their businesses. Individual nonprofits, if somehow they want something that's included, some kind of clause or tax break, or they don't need tax breaks because they're nonprofits, but some type of policy that's important to them, and then consultants as well. And obviously from the government official side, you'd have Congress, committees that are dealing with these individual people. Sometimes political entrepreneurs are available, so there may be somebody that's outside of a committee structure, but they're really interested in that policy area, and they will work with these people as well. And then, of course, we have the executive branch, generally within the Iron Triangle kind of bureaucracies are the ones that talk the most. So here's what I want to do. My key, if I like the status quo, is to exclude other players from getting involved in my sandbox, my Iron Triangle, right? So basically, the Iron Triangle is set up with a small number of players who work together to keep issues from becoming public so that we can make the decisions without the public getting involved. And if I like the status quo, keeping decision-making out of the public is a great idea. Right? Because if it gets into the public realm, I might lose control of the issue. All right. So, for example, for many years, the Iron Triangle for transportation was, basically the Department of Transportation and state highway builders and the companies that build highways. And the idea of mass transportation was not part of the highway your transportation system until the 1960s. And all of a sudden, that Iron Triangle broke open, and the mass transit people were able to build their way into the transportation cycle when it had only been road builders before then, right? So the Iron Triangle works when we have fewer groups, because that means less conflict, and definitely keep yourself out of the public eye. Now, why does the Iron Triangle work? How is it possible that we could actually have these kind of little sub-governments running all over Washington, D.C. without anybody paying attention to them? Well, here's the way we can think about it. There are two different levels of what we can call processing. And Baumgartner and Jones call it serial versus parallel processing. And if you know anything about developmental psychology, think in terms, or if you just have kids, if you've ever gone around and been in a nursery school and there are, you know, five or six kids sitting around that are maybe 1.5, 2 years old, they're all playing, right? They're all playing with blocks, but they're not playing together. And we call that parallel play, right? They're all around with each other, but nobody's working together. And Congress really is like a group of, you know, 1.5 to 2 year olds in that they engage in parallel play most of the time. In other words, it's impossible for every member of Congress to be able to deal with each issue that's before Congress. So they specialize in different areas, and that creates this subsystem of policy that works on issues and allows hundreds of different things to go on all at one time. And for the most part, only the people that are interested in that, i.e. interested in the issue that's before the Iron Triangle, is looking at it during the parallel processing stage. Now, the problem with that is that sometimes you need big reform or you need big public policies to be passed. And that's what we call serial processing. So while at any given moment in time there are hundreds of different issues being discussed around the Washington community in Congress, there are a couple of things that take precedence over everything else. And all of Congress is dealing with those things at that one point in time. So, for example, the repeal and replace for the Republican Congress of the Affordable Care Act is one of those things that is a serial issue in which all of Congress is working on at one point in time. And three or four issues will percolate up to the top, and that is serial processing. So the difference between serial and parallel processing then is that serial processing is what everybody's working on. Parallel processing is what these iron triangles are working on. And the iron triangle works because of the fact that Congress can't work on every issue all the time. So all these different sub-governments are there.